Today, we will proceed to our final destination, which is the border of America and Canada. We're only 175 miles short, or 282 kilometers short of that final destination. This is your Stevie Walker. Right now, we're here in a rest area before we would continue with our journey towards the border of America and Canada. What I like about driving here in America is that they have this extensive and well-designed rest area where travelers or drivers could have a rest when they feel tired. How I wish one day Philippines would have like this and make this common so that any tourist could conveniently stop before they continue with their journey. Could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have, 'cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down. 'Cause I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top of the world, hey. Been waiting on this for a while now. Pay my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, hey. Been holding it for a while. Good morning, America and Canada. It's great to be here in your world. Get up now, get up. Comes the great Niagara Falls. I could still not believe that one day I would be standing here at the border of America and Canada and see for myself why Niagara Falls is just so magnificent. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have. As you can see, a lot of tourists are going around the park. Tourists coming from Canada would just cross towards America and vice versa. If there's one thing I have learned from this trip, it's just that the American people and the Canadian people live well along its border. That makes the place progressive and peaceful. How I wish one day Filipinos would learn to live well with each other, making our boundaries something that don't matter. I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top of the world, hey. Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, hey. Been holding it for a while, hey. Taking with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. Falling down.
whoo, finally we're seeing the great Niagara Falls. I remember when I was a kid, I would see a photo of this on a postcard in a bookstore, and I could not believe that I could be here someday. If you wonder why this falls is so majestic, it is because of the fact that the four Great Lakes, Superior, Michigan, Huron, and Erie, converged to make this Niagara Falls, and the waters travel down to Lake Ontario on the side of Canada. That's the majestic Niagara Falls.
I've tried to cut these corners, tried to take the easy way out. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have, cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down. Cause I'm on top of the world, hey.
In my 2 weeks of travel, which brings me to Korea, America, and the border of Canada, I have noticed that those countries with colder temperature tend to be very progressive, but of course with some outliers. One correlational research study points out that those people who live under cold weather conditions tend to work harder during sunny days and save those valuable resources for the incoming colder days. This nugget of wisdom, when applied to our very lives, may spell the difference between poverty and prosperity. This is your Stevie Walker. Now, get up.